YouTube. I still receive a lot of comments and letters and suggestions to make more English videos and more videos about Kyiv and Ukraine in general. So I decided that this is a high time to make a new video about Ukraine, in which I'll tell you some more interesting facts about my country. This will be like part two of the video I made like 2 years ago, I think, which you'll find in the description. So go check it out and then come back and find out even more facts about Ukraine. So in the first part, we talked about Ukraine in general, like which countries it borders, what's our national food, clothes, etc. Today I'll be speaking about more specific facts. Today I decided to start with, I'd say, a Christmas-related fact. Although Christmas was like a month ago or something, it doesn't matter. I'm sure that everyone knows that famous Christmas song or carol, Carol of the Bells. Even if you don't know the name of this melody, you heard it a billion times. When I was 10 or even younger, I watched Home Alone for the first time, and I've heard this song. I think it was in the second part when Kevin was in New York, and this was like one of the main themes, music themes in that film. And I thought it sounds so familiar. I've heard it a lot in Ukraine, not knowing it's a soundtrack to the movie or something like this, and I've done a research, so I found out it's called Carol of the Bells. The most interesting thing is that this was originally a Ukrainian carol called Shedrik, and it was composed by Ukrainian composer and musician Mykola Leontovich. This guy, I'll put his photo somewhere here, in early 20th century, like in 1914, something like this. And then it became really popular in America, because I think it was performed by some choir or music band or something like this back then in New York, and it became really, really popular. And now I think many people don't know what's this song originally and who created it, but like we know only that this is Carol of the Bells, this Christmas soundtrack of every year. But yeah, it was composed by Ukrainian, and this is really cool. And here in Ukraine, people still sing the original carol in Ukrainian called Shedrik. And this leads us to the next interesting fact, that many people in Ukraine celebrate Christmas on the 7th of January. I remember I told one of my foreign friends about it, and he was so surprised, and he asked me, why is this so? This is because the most people of Ukraine, I think, celebrate Orthodox Christmas. But there are people in Western Ukraine who celebrate like Catholic Christmas. Is it the right way to call it? Because they're Catholic and Roman Catholic. Roman Catholic? I'm so bad at these definitions. So yeah, I'd say in the center of Ukraine and in Eastern Ukraine, we celebrate Christmas on the 7th of January, and in Western Ukraine, people celebrate it like you do in Western Europe or the USA. And I like Christmas so much because me and my mom and my sister, we always cook 12 dishes. So yeah, there are always 12 dishes without meat on the table. And then when we see the first star at the sky, this means that we can go and eat our Christmas Eve dinner. And yeah, this is really family time, when the whole family gather together and just spend time in a cozy Christmas atmosphere. I like this holiday so much. And let's come back to music. We have this cool music instrument called trembita. I think it's called wind instrument, right? So you blow in it and then there are sounds. This is a traditional Ukrainian instrument, and I believe it's one of the longest wind instruments in the world. It's really cool and the sound is so unique. So I'll put a sound of trompeta somewhere here so you can check it out too. I'd like to listen to trompeta live one day. And another interesting fact about music is that recently many foreign bands have been filming their music videos in Kyiv, and this is so cool. Nothing But Thieves, Falls, Years and Years, this famous Danish singer Mø, all of them filmed their music videos in Kyiv. It was quite recently. I'll link all these videos down in the description, so go check it out. And I'm sure there are a lot more people who filmed it here, but probably I don't know, or they never actually mentioned that they film in Kyiv. You can only find out that it's Kyiv from the comments under their videos. Where people of Kyiv write, "Whoa, this is Kyiv, so cool," or "I live in this house." And speaking about filming in Kyiv, a lot of international brands like Apple, Lacoste, etc., etc., they filmed their ads, like this promo videos, also in Kyiv. I'll link it also down in the description box. And now it's time to speak about some numbers and records. First fact is that here in Kyiv we have the deepest metro station in the world. It's called Arsenalna and it's 105 meters deep. It may sound pretty cool, but the time you spend on the escalator, this is how you call it, this moving stairs, when you go up from the bottom of the station, so long and so boring, but the record it is. And we also have the biggest airplane in the world. It's called Mria in Ukrainian, and it would be the Dream in English. So it was created in that time when Ukraine was a part of the Soviet Union, and it was built for the USSR space program. So this really big plane could transport big parts for spaceships or something like this. I'm not a real expert in this, but it's really, really big. And I can't even believe that this huge machine can fly. I saw pictures of it and I was impressed. It was created in the 1980s and we're still really, really proud of this invention. The next interesting fact is the information that is in my head since school times, is that in Ukraine we had one of the first constitutions in the world. I think in Europe for sure. It was written in 18th century, in the beginning of 18th century, by Ukrainian Hetman Pilip Orlik. Hetman was like a commander of Ukrainian Cossacks. You should have heard something about Ukrainian Cossacks. It was like the big army, the warriors. That constitution gave these Cossacks the democratic rights. It's actually called Pacts and Constitutions of Rights and Freedoms of the Zaporizhian Host. And Wikipedia says that it established a democratic standard for the separation of powers in government, and the constitution limited the executive authority of the Hetman and established a democratically elected Cossack parliament. As far as I know, this constitution wasn't implemented properly, but for sure it's not forgotten today. And every pupil in school knows that we Ukrainians had one of the first constitutions in the world. I felt proud for sure when I found out about it in the fifth grade. The last fact I wanted to tell you is not really that serious and important, but some sources say that here in Kyiv, Ukraine, we have one of the busiest McDonald's in the world. Like one of the most crowded and busiest. I'm not sure it's true, Because I've only found this information on some suspicious websites. I don't really believe them and I don't even know where they got this information. But listen to me, this McDonald's is situated really close to the central railway station. So if you are traveling by train, all you should do is just arrive in Kyiv to the central railway station. Just go out and go check by yourself whether is McDonald's looks crowded enough to be called the busiest, or is it just a lie? So yeah, go and see it yourself and make your own conclusion. This is it for today. I hope you liked this video and it was interesting and maybe a little bit helpful for you. I don't know how it could be helpful, but anyway, I hope you liked it. And if you have some questions to me about Ukraine and life here or Kyiv or just to me as a Ukrainian in general, you can leave your question in the comments and then I'll make a video answering your questions, because I don't really know what should I film and what is interesting for you. So yeah, if you have any questions, leave it in the comments and I'll answer them in the next video. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye! Only German words in my head. Only German. God damn it. It's time to speak about some numbers.